Hello guys and welcome to a brand new video. Today I'm here with Shaman King episode number 2. Alright, the previous episode, it was the beginning of the show and it was quite good. And we got introduced to our main characters. First, the main protagonist is, I think his name was Yo. And we met two or three more characters. There was this, I think, who would probably become his friend, Manta. And the spirit of the great swordsman that he met, the spirit of that great swordsman, Amidamaru, I think his name was. I'll need to start remembering the names. So we met these new characters and there was this like whole little story of Amidamaru, like what, like he and his friend who was the best swordsmith. There's like a little backstory, a sad little backstory. And Amidamaru, by the end of it, decides to accompany Yo because Yo has this power of fusing souls and like using the power of the souls, I'm guessing. So it's quite a unique type of not superpower, but a technique that I've seen in, you know, I think this is the first time I've seen it in an anime. Like the only place I've seen fusion is like Dragon Ball Z, like the whole fusion of like was that Goku, Vegeta and Goten and Trunks, like that was the only fusion I've seen, at least in anime. And this is, I think, the second show that we see like fusing of souls to make a completely new entity. So I'm quite excited to see like what, like new, like this brings a lot of possibilities, how this power can be, you know, like utilized in the upcoming episodes. There's a lot of things we can think about regarding this power. So let's see what, you know, like what the upcoming episodes bring. So yeah guys, without further ado, let's get started with the second episode of Shaman King. Alright, I'll be putting the subtitles and the timer here, sync it to whichever is your preference, and let's get started. Alright, so here's the countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. Oyamada Manta. Asakura Yo. Amidamaru, okay. I need to start remembering the names. Guardian Ghost. Okay. His friend with the ghost, yeah. Oh. Oh, who is this? New character? Oh, we saw him in the, I think, in the previous episode in the end. Then we'll stop. Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah, we have signs. Oh my God. Damn, his dress is sparkling. Oh, damn. His golden jacket, golden suitcase. Okay. Then. Oh, who is this? Another. Damn. He also has, oh! He also has a soul companion. So he's also a shaman. Oh, there's that guy, we can see him. Like in the silhouette. Either he'll become a good friend of Yo, or he'll kind of be like a, you know, kind of a rival type of an entity to Yo. Oh, we can see him on a horse. Song's quite nice. Yeah, he will become his friend. I can see that. And we're also seeing a few other characters as well. There's a guy on a wheelchair. Okay. And that Pompadour guy as well. Oh, he has a shield as well. Okay, like obviously, like if there's Amida Maru is like a swordsman, there must be someone who is like a, you know, shieldsman or something. Shieldsman, is that a word? I don't know. So these two are like, I think the main characters, the Yo and the other girl, I think. Like the main characters, I'm guessing. Ghost of a Chinese warlord. Yeah, obviously, like yeah. Okay. Okay. Oh, he doesn't know him. Unless he forgot. Okay. Magnificent. Chinese warlord, okay. First shaman friend. The only Chinese warlord I at least know is Ryofu, isn't it? Or Lugu as they call him. Ah, there he is. Okay. Damn. Oh, he kicked it. Oh my God, he broke the. Oh, so he is like a person who like wants everything to be environmental friendly. Okay. Ooh. Oh, Kung Fu. Well, with his ghost, I'm guessing he's even stronger. Damn. Oh, what is that? Bason. His name is Bason? Oh, damn. What the? Okay. Well. Yeah. Oh my God, they're alive! Like, I thought they died. Yeah, you should probably not kill. Well, like everyone is polluting, so like down in. Oh, damn. Okay, yeah. No. I don't think he wants to make friends. Oh, great. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Okay, well, Okay, let's see how actually strong like Yo is, you know? Okay, you're pissing him off, I think. Yeah. Okay. Now we'll see like two shamans fighting. Like we can like gauge Yo's power level better in this way. Damn, he has a like literal spear and this guy's using a rod or whatever, like a pipe, steel pipe. Oh. Okay. Okay, calm down. God. Like he's using a spear and like one-sided. Okay, well, percent integration. Oh, he's completely fusing or something. Oh. Okay, oh Lord. Damn, your dress got God. Tauren, okay, I need to remember his name. And that's Bason or Bason. Where did he get stabbed? Like in his hand? Dominate. Oh, okay, so he's saying that whoever has the upper hand Like, so that's why, like, we use them as a tool. Yeah, it's going to, like, yeah, contradictory sometimes. Okay. Okay, well, I'll drive. I'm gonna... Okay, well, where did he get stabbed? Yeah, in his arm. Oh yeah, well. Oh, wait! There you see, like Amida Mara saved him because of two souls. If it was only his soul, he would have died. That's like an advantage. Yeah, like he needs to control his power or utilize it better. Oh. Because causes of heat. Oh. That's true. Well, there you go. What do you do now? Oh. Okay, bus on, let's see. And there we go again. Oh, what the? Yeah, I was thinking. Oh. But he said that, like, there. Yeah, like, how did he do that? Because it's like two souls. Oh, if they both think the same, you know? Okay. Yeah, as I was saying, if they both think the same and, like. Yeah, there you go. That's another way to do it, you know? Okay. Like now their minds are like the same. Like they're thinking the same, doing the same thing. That's why their power is so like elevated and he can like do the 100% integration. Okay. Let's put it into test then. There you go. Yes, you realize that now? Okay. But yeah, he needs more training, obviously. Oh, this is his childhood? 4 years? What? Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, so he did not want to. Unfortunately, that's not how this world works. People need guidance to survive on this planet. Ultimate omniscient spirit. Oh, King of Spirits. Okay. Oh, yeah. So, only someone who has become one with the King of Shaman King. Oh, okay. Okay, so he didn't want to become a shaman, but he wants to become a Shaman King. Okay, I can kind of understand what he is thinking. Like, he doesn't want to be a small fry, he wants to be the big guy. Oh, that is his motivation. That Oh, this is that girl from the opening. Wait, she knows him? It seems like she knows him. Oh, damn! Okay. Oh, she's also a shaman. Anna the Itaku. Fiance? Wait, what? Oh, that came as a surprise. Oh, so that. All right. So that's why in the opening we can kind of see them together. Okay, that was a good second episode, and we met two new characters. Three if you include Bason as well. So One thing I can see in this show is that it has a lot of characters. Like in the openings especially, like you can see like so many people and so many characters. So I'm guessing the first few episodes there, look at it. Like we can see Bason, Ken, that Pompadour guy, and a few other characters. There's a skeleton as well. So yeah, as I was saying, so I'm guessing they're going to spend the first few episodes, first 5 or 6 episodes, introducing the characters. That's usually how like these type of shows go. Like, you know, these like long running shows. Obviously this is like, it is kind of a long running show, like, you know, 52 episodes, that's quite long. But yeah, as I was saying, so like they're going to like introduce the new characters in the first few episodes, then gradually I'm guessing we're going to get into the actual story, you know. All right, that's the end. So yeah, as I was saying, so this episode, we see like a new character. Like his name is, I think, Ken. Was his name Ken? Just a sec, let me check. No, Ren. Oh, I mistook his name. Anyways, his name is Ren. Okay. Oh my god, these names, I need to start remembering them. It's like, okay, his name is Ren. All right. So we met Ren. He's like a guy who is quite pissed off at the people because, you know, like all the pollution that they're doing, and he thinks like people who are polluting the environment so much, they are not even worthy of, you know, like being like being alive or something like that. Like he was treating those guys who were using the car and saying that, oh, like you guys are the owner of that car which is polluting the environment, so I don't think you deserve to live. So it's like a little bit, you know, what can you say, a bit extreme. But I think obviously like this new character Ren, he must have like, you know, lived, like he's a shaman, so he has lived with the nature and everything from his childhood, and that kind of like shows his like appreciation towards the nature, and he knows that like we are destroying the nature and like, you know, with the polluting and everything. So that's why he like him with his personality of like this no nonsense type of a personality, is he just said that, okay, like you guys are polluting the environment, you don't deserve to live. So yeah, but he needs to like, you know, like everyone is polluting the environment in some way. So like according to him, like that means like the whole humanity should be wiped out. Like that's not an answer, but I can kind of get it that he is like not well versed with the modern things, I'm guessing. But yeah, and another thing that he had kind of a wrong kind of what can I say, impression, not impression, but a wrong way of advancing, is that he like treats the souls of the, you know, the souls that he is fusing with them as tools. And in a way, like, okay, so his point of view is like, if I think that, yeah, the souls are my friend, we are friends, then we won't be able to harness the full power. Because his explanation is pretty easy to understand. He says that if it's like my friend, we have two souls in our body, and it might like the obviously like if they're like two different souls, so the decisions they're going to make might differ. For example, there is like someone like charging at you with a weapon. Now you might think that, oh, I'll dodge to the left, but your soul might think I will dodge to the right. So that will make the decision-making skills a lot lesser, and it will take a lot more time. So that's like, according to him, like that is the like big disadvantage of that. So he says that, okay, I'll use it as a tool. Now here's another thing. You know, if like you used the Amida Maru just like how Ren is using Bason, I think he would have died in this episode. Not died, but he would have been like heavily injured, because like he was unable to take a decision, unable to dodge when that like spear came towards his direction. I think like they said in this episode that Amida Maru like helped him dodge. So if he had used Amida Maru as a tool, It would have been like he would have been using only his soul, like, you know, his soul, and Amidamar would be just a tool. It would not be able to take any decisions. At that moment, he would have been heavily injured because Amidamaru does not have any will. If he is used as a tool, would not have any, like, you know, own will. So he would not be able to dodge at that moment, and he would have gotten hurt very badly. So I think that was like kind of way to show us that, like, using like, you know, the souls as tools is not the only answer. But yeah, I can kind of understand his like point of view, like, you know, like, however, like, how much friends you are, like, obviously there might be some kind of discrepancy, yeah, while making decisions, taking decisions. And like, as he said, explained that like, you won't be able to take a single decision, you might like differ. So that, and then like, I kind of thought, and like later on you also like used that, is that if like, okay, like you're saying that if your soul and you think two different things, it might reduce, you know, it might reduce the, what can I say, like the f the like result, and it will take a lot more longer time to take decisions. But the reverse is true, you know, the reverse of this. If they go towards the same decision, it will fasten it, like it will like the speed will get even in will increase if they take a same decision. Just think about it like this. There are two cars. They are like, what can I say? Not cars. Let me take another example. There are two forces. These two forces are going in opposite directions. So that's why, like, whichever like force's power is greater, it will like kind of like drag the other force in that direction. That's how he is saying the decision making, like the decision making time and the effort to make the decisions will increase. You can see? But if both the forces go towards the same direction, it will be even more than a single force. Like, it will be two, like, if one force is one and another force is one, it will be like 1 + 1 = 2. So the strength will increase. So in this way, he can even, like, Yo can even harness more power than like Ren was able to do in this episode by like treating Basin as a tool. I hope I'm able to make, you know, explain properly. I'm sure you guys can understand what I'm trying to say. So like, it's not just that he is like, it's like his power is doubled if they like go towards the same direction, goes makes the same decision. But the like thing that, yeah, we will have to make the same decisions at the same time. That is a bit difficult, you know. That's why, like, you'll have to, I'm guessing, the teamwork factor is a bit more here. So that means, like, if they are able to properly do the teamwork, Yo can like become more powerful than the shamans who use their the souls as tools. So like, the shamans who use this the souls as a tools will only get a, like, you know, a single power, the single power of the soul and his tools power. But like, Yo in this situation, he gets double the power. He gets his soul's power and like Amidamaru's soul's power as well, which are like going towards the same direction. It will be increased. So that's one thing. That's just something that I thought, you know, when they were like kind of explaining it. So yeah, I'm guessing that will be kind of like the trump card that, you know, Yo has, that he like treats his souls as his friends. And that will like help him in the long run. But yeah, but anyways, like, we kind of saw in this episode only, like, when they were like doing it at the, like, when they were like synchronizing it like 100%, they were able to defeat Ren in just a flash. So that kind of shows that, yeah, like the power like got doubled. And Ro, like Ren, who uses his soul, the soul as a tool, he got defeated in front of Yo and Amidamaru. But yeah, so that was like the main thing in this episode. And there was like, what can I say, I'm guessing like this guy, like Ren, will gradually like change his mind on the whole like using the soul as a tool. after, because obviously he kind of saw the result in front of his eyes. Like, you proved him wrong. I'm guessing he'll also change his methods. And I'm thinking, like, one thing I'm thinking, are these souls that, like, Amida Maru, Bason, are they, like, real people who, like, lived, or it's just something that the anime made up? I don't know. Like, you know, like, is there, like, any, like, famous samurai like this Amida Maru, who, like, really lived? I don't know, like, there are like some animes who do this, you know, kind of bring like people who have actually like lived in our world and take the name and kind of introduce into anime. I was thinking, was it something like that, or this is just something the anime, you know, the anime like made up his characters anyways. And yeah, and then in the next scene we see like a little bit of a flashback of Yo. And okay, now here's a funny thing. Okay, this, like, I'm guessing that's his like master or grandfather, like, who was teaching Yo, and he says that like, Yo, you have must become a shaman, and Yo says that, nah, I don't want to become a shaman. And then, like, when his grandfather, the grandfather that old guy, he like explains that shamans are like this type of a person, like, they're like shaman kings, they become like the strongest, you know, person, and they are like extremely strong and all of these kind of things, he says. And then, like, Yo says that, okay, I'll become the Shaman King. Now, I thought at that moment that, oh, like, so he doesn't want to become a small fry. Even like small fry shamans, he doesn't want to be that. That's why, like, when he like heard that the Shaman King is like the strongest, he thought that, yeah, I'll become the strongest. I won't be like these kind of small fries. I'll become the strongest. So that's why his motivation, you know, got higher. Turns out that's not the case. He has other things in mind. He is becoming a shaman because he wants to laze around. And I think that's a pretty, what can I say? Like, that's a pretty impressive like reason for doing this, because, you know, what can I say? Like, it's a pretty unique reason for becoming stronger. Like, so that he can become like, he can laze around and give, like, spend his life in like luxury. That's a pretty like impressive and a pretty like a reason which we usually do not see in shonen animes. Like, I do not think I've ever what can I say, like, heard of a shonen anime where the main, like, you know, the main protagonist said that, oh, I will become this because I want to live my life in luxury. I don't think I've heard, like, Naruto wanted to become Hokage. What else? In Bleach, Ichigo. What did Ichigo even want? I forgot. Ichigo's case is a bit different. He had like circumstances, so I'm not taking Ichigo's situation into account. In One Piece, Luffy wants to become the Pirate King, and what else? Like, these kind of things. Like, there's like these kind of, in My Hero Academia, like, Deku wants to become the strongest. And like all of these like, you know, these different kind of like motivational goals they have. Whereas Yo wants to become the strongest so that he can laze around in luxury. That's brilliant. I love that like reasoning, and I think that's like the best reasoning and one of the most, like, what can I say, like, according to our standards, the most realistic, you know, because we all want to become, you know, like, why do we want, like, for them, like, it's like becoming the strongest. For us, like, normal people, it's like, what kinds of getting a better job or doing like some good things, earning more money. Why? So that we can like live in luxury. It's the same thing. So, like, you know, like we as audience who are like watching this show, we can relate better. I love that reasoning. That was really good, and I was really impressed. As like, I've never heard a shonen anime protagonist say something like that in like ever. But yeah, and then in the end, we this new girl comes in. Her name is Anna Itako, I think. Yeah, Anna. Says I'm a shaman, Anna da Itako. What is an Itako? I'm sure we'll get explanation later on. But her name is Anna. Okay. Or Anna or Anna. I'll call her Anna. I'm not sure But anyway, what did she? Anna, okay. She herself says Anna, not Anna. Anna. Okay, so we get this new character, and she says that she's the fiance of Yo. Now, I'm sure we'll get more explanations in the next episode. And I was really not expecting this. I thought maybe like she maybe just like childhood friends, you know? But turns out like she's the fiance. Okay, I'm sure we'll get like more explanations in the next episode. And yeah, I'm looking forward to like for the next episodes, like how this is going to go. Like I'm really liking this, the way this is going, like you know, and the whole power thing is quite unique as well, like the whole fusion of the souls. And yeah, like this is quite enjoyable. So yeah guys, that was episode number 2 of Shaman King. So if you guys enjoyed my reaction, be sure to press the like button and subscribe if you're new to the channel or you haven't subscribed. Consider doing so because that will help me a lot. And comment down below anything you want to say or anything you want to share, any of your opinions about this anime. I'll definitely be checking them out. So yeah guys, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next week, same time, with another episode of Shaman King. So until then, goodbye and have a nice day.